Brand new designs are up on the Edge Redbubble, werewolves, spiders, FedEx amphibians, proto crocs, and more. Go check out the Redbubble with links in the description and comments section below. Millipedes are among the earliest animals to walk on land and breathe oxygen straight from the atmosphere. Some extinct species could grow up to 10 feet, 3 meters. They've been around for more than 400 million years and are among the most important decomposers on the planet. They're the garbage men of Earth's ecosystems. Just as the earthworm tills the soil and breaks down detritus, the millipede chows down almost exclusively on rotten foliage, which helps break down dead material and return elements to the Earth's many cycles. Despite their importance to the sustainability of the planet and its diversity of life, knowledge of the millipede lags behind that of other animal groups. This is helped in no small way by how small and hidden many millipedes tend to be. For instance, one brand spanking new species has just been published that carries with it some of the most bizarre millipede traits ever seen, as well as brandishing the most legs of any living thing on the planet. Meet the true millipede, Eumillipes Persephone. A team of Australian biologists have been setting traps across the goldfield regions of Western Australia for a few months. They set the traps in 56, 4 to 81 meter, 13 to 196 foot deep, 150 millimeter, 6 inch diameter drill holes, created for mineral exploration. Their traps are specifically designed to trap subterranean species, known as troglofauna. They're basically just PVC pipes with holes that they drop down the holes and cover so normal bugs don't get caught. Rotting leaves were put in as bait, and the traps were left to do their thing for months. When they retrieved the traps, brought them back to the lab, and prepared everything that had been caught, they found something truly extraordinary. 8 individuals of a new species of millipede were the reward. Here's the weird part about millipedes. Their name means a thousand foot, but none have ever been found with a thousand little feetsies. It's a metaphorical name given to these creatures long before there were Latinized scientific designations. It's assumed the name was given to them probably because why the hell would you want to literally count all the legs? It looks like there's gotta be a thousand of them, so the name stuck. The leggiest millipede ever found was Elacmi plenipes from California with up to 750 legs. Until Eumillipes was thrown under a microscope and Virginia Tech entomologist Paul Merrick counted each leg. The new animal has 1,306 legs. This makes it officially the leggiest animal on the planet. This makes it the first true millipede, the first millipede with millipedes. The number of legs isn't the only thing that makes these things weird. Before placing the millipede under the microscope, Merrick thought it might belong to a lineage of California millipedes called Siphonophorida. Siphonophorida, yeah. They're noodly, colorless, eyeless, beaked, cone-headed, mini-mandibled, and live in the soil. The reason for the comparison is that the new 1,300-leg mini-beast is also colorless, as a cone-shaped head, a beak, is rather wormy or noodly, has no eyes, and huge antennae. The thing is that the Californian lineage has no members living in Australia. Once the thing was put under the scope, it became clear the Australian millipede belonged to an Australian endemic lineage of millipedes called the Polyzoniida. This means that the similarity between the Californian millipedes and this new one is an example of extreme convergent evolution, where distinct species developed similar anatomies due to similar life habits rather than shared ancestry. This was further confirmed by genomic testing on a new millipede. The extreme number of legs and wormy body allows Eumillipes to move through the soil in an efficient manner. It finds an opening with its antennae and walks through it using its thousandfold legs to push itself forward. These Polyzoniidan millipedes don't start out this long. When they're born, they only have 8 legs. As they age, they grow more segments and more legs. Most only start growing segments and legs at sexual maturity, but Eumillipes seems to grow longer throughout their lives. They have no eyes because they live in constant darkness, just like the critters that live in caves. This is also why they lack any coloration. They don't need to blend in when they can't see anything and no one else can see them. Its comparatively extreme length may be an adaptation to increase the length of its gut, to increase the efficiency of absorption of nutrients. Waste not, want not. Though it is comparatively long, it's really tiny overall, only 95.7 millimeters, 3.7 inches long. Since the soil beneath our feet is some of the most understudied habitats for organisms, besides the ocean, it remains highly probable that there are many more weird millipedes beneath the soil of Australia. Only time will tell if they live long enough for us to describe them. For more interesting stories about nature, the history of life, or what goes bump in the night, subscribe, hit the bell icon for updates, like this video, and drop a comment in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Special thanks goes to my elephant tier patrons, Thea Svensson, Staniforth Hopkins, Dinosaur, Chris Frampton, Biotaverse, Arda Bayer, and Christoph Hubinger, as well as my Tyrannosaur patrons, Iron Bladesman, Henry Brennan, Danny Van Heck, and Dana Manchester.